Adelante, bienvenida. Estoy sobando la parte del nervio asiático. Que mucha gente padece de este nervio.
Sí.
El nervio asiático que padece esta. La nieta ya sabe sobar. La hija. Mírate. Es un nervio que se mete aquí en medio de la columna, que lo padece muchísima gente. Hay que sacarlo del nervio de la columna, de la pierna, la sentadera y acá la parte de la corva, que duele tanto. Hay un 90% que padecen de este nervio. Parte del nervio asiático que se viene mucho a la cabeza, mucha gente lo padece y se les hace el parálisis facial. Y dicen que no saben por qué, porque el nervio asiático se jaló tanto que fue a dar hasta la cara. Uy. Y como pueden ver, ahí está. Y de todos los santos que tengo aquí, son regalos que la gente me trae por el agradecimiento de que les pude servir. Y son regalos que me dan. Entonces, esa es su consultorio pobre que tengo aquí para servir, pero aquí estoy sirviéndoles a toda la comunidad, toda mi gente, los que pueden y no pueden pagar, aquí son bienvenidos.
I've been seeing Doña María for probably like 2.5 years now. I've been coming because in my job I have to bend down a lot and carry a lot of merchandise, so my back is always hurting. And before I used to have insurance, I used to go with the physical therapist, but I didn't really think that helped. But then I started coming here because I also lost my health insurance. And it's different. It's way better here because you can see a doctor, you can see a therapist, but they don't really know you. Like Doña Maria, she knows my family, she knows my community. She knows my problems because it's so easy to open up to her and like just tell her everything your life is going through. And it's really great because you leave feeling physically well and mentally and emotionally, and you just don't get that from the medical field. Personally, I got referred to her by one of my coworkers, so I came and she made a big difference in my well-being. And then I found out that many of my coworkers come here. So, and also my cousin came here to get sobada, and she levantó la matriz, like I think have something with the womb. And 2 weeks later she was pregnant, so she's a big help to this community.
Pasa de generación en generación, se trabaja, hay muchas maneras de curar. Por ejemplo, en México tienen una cultura, que en Guatemala otra, en Chile otra, en Perú otra, aquí otra, y aquí con la que trabajamos más es con el cuerpo, el sobando, parte de hierbas medicinales, la otra de matriz, ovarios, todo lo que es de la mujer, se trabaja mucho en eso. Aquí trabajo yo en esas tres partes que son las más importantes de lo que yo he tenido mi experiencia en todo el tiempo que he trabajado aquí. El curanderismo, lo que trato uno de servir es que es mejor que mucha medicina, que mucho de los... Trato uno de servir para que se sientan mejor del alma, del cuerpo y mente. Trabajando con eso, uno, aparte de que uno da su buena energía, ayuda a mucha gente y se queda uno a gusto de poder servirles. soy María Barajas, trabajo de muchos años aquí con muchas plantas medicinales, con hierbas. He trabajado con diferentes clínicas de la área de la bahía. Soy la quinta generación trabajando en esto. Mis antepasados siempre han curado con plantas, hierbas, y a través de esto puedo yo servirles sobando. Es más sobar que masaje, porque es diferente el masaje, y la sobada se puede tocar y sentir lo que la persona trae, más que todo física, mental y de dolor, de todo se puede ayudar. Aquí conmigo vienen a buscar ayuda porque no tienen los medios que se necesitan para ir a un doctor. Aquí conmigo encuentran terapia, medicinas, tesis, uh-huh, y cualquier cosa que esté al servicio mío, yo les puedo ayudar. Tengo muchos años trabajando en esto y les puedo servir en cuestión de salud mental, uh-huh, física y corporalmente, porque todo se necesita. Con plantas todo se cura. Hay muchos remedios que tiene uno en su casa y no sabe uno ni para qué son. Entonces tenemos muchas plantas medicinales que a través de raíces y plantas, a hojas, todo nos puede servir si sabes para qué. Yo no he estudiado para esto nada. Esto es algo que es lírico, que Dios me ha dado esto que sé. Primero Dios, todas las plantas que sé, 420 remedios caseros son nomás por de memoria. No tengo acceso a computadoras, a nada. Todo es lírico, todo se lo puedo dar de pregunta, cualquier cosa que quiera un remedio para algo, y yo estoy dispuesta a dárselo. Pues mira, aquí vienen de todo tipo de personas, de todas las razas, de americanos, de hindús, chinitos, mexicanos, de todas las razas vienen conmigo, y de toda la clase, y especialmente mucha gente que necesita ayuda porque no encuentran casa, están muy tensos porque no, por migración, porque no tienen para ir al doctor, porque muchas cosas, que vienen aquí muy enfermos. A partir de que muchos están internados y vienen familiares y me llevan a los hospitales donde están internados sus familiares, y voy a los hospitales también a sobarlos. He trabajado con todas las clínicas de la raza, la cultura y bienestar, el hospital de los niños, de Children. He trabajado hasta, me han mandado hasta Utah a sobar niños que están enfermos en el hospital. He trabajado con todas las clínicas que están aquí en la bahía, he trabajado con todas las clínicas, la de la A, la de la B, todas las clínicas he trabajado con eso, Manteca, Sacramento, Modesto, Stockton, y pues toda la área he trabajado con todas las clínicas. Por favor, acompáñenme, voy a enseñarles lo que son todas las plantas que tenemos para la comunidad, para los servicios de los remedios.
Ok.
La sábila, el romero, hasta el maguey, hasta los remedios del maguey, que ayuda para mucha gente que de la menopausia. Este es el romero para la menopausia y para la gente que padece mucho del gastritis. Mm-hmm. Aquí está el orégano, mira abajo. Este es el orégano. Okay. Muy importante para la gente que quiera el ajenjo, para las viles, mira. El ajenjo, este es ajenjo para las viles. Este es el ajenjo. Y acá tenemos, ya le doy la vuelta al nicle, ya está. Mira, esta planta es naranjo agrio. Trabajo un 90% con este remedio de aquí. Primero, este es al azar. Para la gente que no puede dormir, mucha gente lo compra como 7 azares. Uh-huh. Eso no, 7 azares. Después viene la naranja. De aquí el proceso se pela, se seca, se pone a cocer, la tostamos y la damos para el empacho y para la gente que tiene insomnio, muchos nervios. Hay 100 propiedades curativas de un té de estos de naranja. Como puedes ver, este ya tiene muchas muchas naranjas, que se pueden hacer muchas cosas de aquí. Para mí este es uno de los peces más importantes que trabajo, y el del nicle para la gente que padece de la sangre de anemia. Ahí está el nicle enfrente de ti, mira, este es el que... blanco, muy bueno para el diabetes también. La bienvenida para las vejigas de la boca. La gente que padece las vejigas de la boca, nomás se limpian con una hojita de estas y se quitan las vejigas. Sí, porque tenían un niño muy enfermo allá en Oklahoma y me decían que fuera y que fuera, pero pues yo qué iba a hacer, ya tenía un mes internado allá en el hospital, ya los doctores ya lo habían visto todo, los doctores ya qué iba a hacer yo, y me estuve negando todo el día y todos estuvieron insistiendo de que fuera a verlo. Y ahí fue donde vi que, cuando vi que llegué y sobre el niño, vi la importancia que es mi trabajo, que puedo servir, ayudar a los niños, que cuando ya los doctores no pueden hacer nada, la medicina que nosotros damos, ahí está para servirle. El mejor testimonio se los puede dar mi hija, que ella estuvo traduciendo en inglés, ella se los puede dar.
All right, my name is Stephanie. That was my mom who you were just interviewing. I am
Oh, look like me.
I do! I'm a doppelganger. Anyway. we flew out to Oklahoma after a mom called my mom, very, very desperate, after her son was there at the hospital for like about a month. So pretty much he ate something at a gas station or whatever, did his stomach very, very bad, and the doctors were doing colonoscopies on the kid, a bunch of medicine on him. And you know, it was crazy because the mom, she was so frustrated when we got there, and it was actually really scary because my mom and I were like, what are we doing here in Oklahoma, like, you know? And we got there and they lived in a very, very like humble house, you know, and in a farm, and it was for sure scary, but I had to remind myself that my mom is very wise and she knows what she's doing. The Western side of me was like, okay, like, you know, we can't do this, mom. Like, what if we get sued? What if we, like, you know, this kid dies on us? Like, you know, there's a lot of things. And my mom's like, why are you doubting me? Like, you know, our ancestors did this type of healing millions and millions and millions of times. And, you know, I know what I'm doing. And it was kind of reassuring, but at the same time, I have to admit, I was really scared. So when we seen the little boy, I think he was like, his name was Jose. He was 12 years old. And I saw him on the couch, and when I say skin to bone, the little boy was skin to bone, and hadn't eaten for a whole month. His jaw had locked up because he wasn't eating at all, and I was scared. I wanted to cry, and my mom was just like, okay, let's get to it. And it was interesting because before she started massaging, she was like, I have to do un remedio. It was a
remedy.
Yeah, a remedy, but the remedy was called una sustancia. Mm. And a sustancia, it's pretty much having, like, giving the body back its nutrients, because the boy hadn't ate in a whole month, so he was really, really weak. So my mom was scared to massage him, and him being, like, you know, fainting or whatever it is. So she was like, Stephanie, I need dirt from underneath the tree. And I was like, mom, I don't know where we're at. Like, where am I gonna go get dirt? But the dad was like, oh, I can go get it. So he went. He got dirt from like underneath the tree. I guess it has to be specifically from underneath the tree because it's like there's more nutrients there. And then she grabbed like a cloth. So she laid down the cloth like enough to like go over his belly. She put the dirt, an egg, cinnamon, like the cinnamon stick like crushed, and some rubbing alcohol. And then she lit it up, and then she folded the cloth and then put it on his belly button and then wrapped it around. And I kid you not, like maybe in 30 minutes, like she checked it again and the egg wasn't there. Like somehow it had dissolved, and the little kid was like starting to like talk a little bit, like, you know. So I was just like, okay, this is like interesting. So then she did that, and when you think about Western medicine, right, you don't think about that stuff, like an egg, dirt, cinnamon, like alcohol. You're like, yeah, what is this, like witchcraft shit, you know? So it was really interesting to see my mom just pulling back this ancestral knowledge that she had, you know, and again, it was really humbling to experience that. So once she did that, oh, she did say that you could only do three in like in one day. So like she wanted to do all three throughout our time that we were there. So what's it called? She did the first one when we landed there around 6, so she did the first one like around 8. Sustancia. So she did the first sustancia, and then that was about 8, and then we waited an hour or two. My mom trying to massage him, and he was just like, just his like agonizing pain was like so unbearable for me to like hear that I had to leave the room, because I was just like, again, my Western views were like, Steph, like, you need to get out of here, like, you know, make sure everything's okay. Like, I was tripping out because this little kid is like really sick. And and the hospital, the doctors had told him that pretty much he had to wait until he passed. Like, that's what they told the parents, like, you know what, we don't know what's going on with your kid, like, you pretty much have to let him like die, you know. So having that in my head already, and seeing him and seeing my mom do her thing, I was really scared, you know. So what's it called, point being, my mom's she massages him, and he's just crying, but he's not like, he's crying, not like, ah, like, you know, screaming, like, he's so weak that he can't even do that. So the tears are just like rolling down his like face. And I think about it, it just gets me kind of emotional, because I could just like sympathize with his parents and with him, right? So after that happened, my mom did another sustancia. That was the second one of the night, and it was around like 10, 11:30. So it was a long night for us. And my mom let him rest, didn't touch him at all. And about 12, like 1-ish, she massaged him again. This point, I was really, really scared. Like, I was scared throughout the whole thing. But at this point, she's massaging him, and I'm there, and she's just like, just pray with me. And I was like, oh my God, like, I don't even know how to pray. So I was like, God, please, I like, just help my mom, like, you know, like, come help her. And like, my mom's just like in her zone, like, totally like ignoring everything, like, just in her zone, just her and Jose. And all of a sudden, like, she like does something to like right here of his stomach, and like he kind of like I thought he fainted. I really thought he fainted. So because he just like closed his eyes, and then he came back, and it was just like and he just like took a really deep breath in, and then that's when he really started crying. And after that, and it gives me chills, because after that he fell asleep for like an hour, maybe like an hour and like almost 2 hours. Like, he fell asleep for forever. His parents were kind of scared. They're like, Doña Maria, like, you know, is he okay? She's like, yes, just let him rest, you know. So during that time that he was sleeping, my mom was preparing the third sustancia to when he would wake up, so she could do it, put it on him. And he woke up, my mom put the sustancia, and he was actually talking already. He's like, oh, like, thank you so much, like, you know, I had a dream that that there was an angel telling me, like, oh, come to me, come to me, come to me. And people were laughing, and I didn't want to come. And then he's like, when I opened my eyes, I seen you. And I was just like, oh, like, tears, a dad, the mom is crying, you know. And then my mom puts the sustancia on the third and last one, and he falls again asleep. When he wakes up, he didn't wake up until the next day. And when he woke up, he was like, oh, I'm hungry, like, I want to eat. And it was just like so such a beautiful moment, because his parents were crying, my mom was crying, his grandma was crying, like, they were just in shock, because they really thought they were gonna lose their child. It was crazy to think that, you know, his parents weren't being heard, right? They were advocating for him, they were advocating for his health, for his their son, right, to stay alive. And the doctors were totally dismissive, and when they were like, you know what, I know someone, I want to bring them in. And I forgot to add, they told the doctor that they wanted to bring my mom in into the hospital, but they didn't want to be responsible for that, even though they were like so like adamant about, like, you know what, she could help us, like, this is maybe like her expertise. And they were like, no, like, you know, again, very Western views of being you know.
Okay, baby, go over there, because we're recording a video, honey. Go over there, baby.
It's not on Kaya. My mom just gave us all your remedy. Important, because it brings hope and voice to those families who are oppressed by these big medical companies, right? Or these systems or institutions. And instead of oppressing, I guess my mom is fighting against it. And, you know, proving that Western medicine isn't the only remedy or the only answer. So definitely, I think it's important, and I hope to learn from her. And
ahora mis hijas quiero que la estén cultivando, que no se les olvide, y ahora después a poquito mis nietas, porque también ya saben de los remedios. Los remedios de las nietas. Mira las naranjas, porque corten, Andy, y después corten una. Ay, carajas, no quisieron cortar ni una. Mira, duélele eso para que veas. Mira, no se quede, toma. Chúpale esta ojita, no tiene.
Okay.
Me quiere. Pero chupa la ojita esa. La quieren, chupa la puesta aquí.
A ver.
De allí, chúpala. No, chúpala.
Oh, wow, está bien dulce.
Es como si te asaren, mira.
Wow.
Mira qué bonito.
Ok.
Pájenme activa el que puedo servir en la comunidad, porque sin que me paguen, yo les puedo servir, yo puedo dejar hasta de comer para servirles. A mí me pagan con lo que pueden, hasta me traen fruta, me traen comida, lo que sea. Yo estoy agradecida con ellos porque puedo servirles de esa manera. Y espero poder servirles un buen tiempo, hasta que Dios quiera, porque yo creo que me necesita y debería haber más gente como yo que pueda servir a la comunidad y sin esperar nada a cambio poderles servir, porque hay mucha necesidad en nuestra gente. Ay, no van a tirarnos, vernos bien.
Okay.
Y una cosa más, ya.